Yeah, there's quite a lot of hype surrounding the Soundcore Liberty 3 Pro earbuds. They are the best thing that have ever been released next to. They sound much better than any other earbuds. They are a insert your favorite bud name here, killer yada yada yada. Let's be real from the get-go. I originally wanted to compare them with the Sony WF-1000XM4s, the flagship earbuds that cost, well, almost double of what the 3 Pros do. Due to them being hyped to the moon by other YouTubers and reviewers. I won't. There's nothing to compare. The Sonys are better in everything. Sound quality, noise cancellation, battery runtime, design, fit, and even, well, the Sony app has more functions. But to be clear, this is what I expected from a twice as expensive tech product. The XM4s are, without a doubt, the best buds that have been released in 2021, and therefore are allowed to cost a premium price. The real question should rather be, how did Soundcore make the Liberty 3 Pros this hyped so that everyone thinks they punch above the earbud weight class and in some parts even outclass higher priced competitors? I'm going to compare them with the nothing ear ones because to me these are the buds in 2021 that actually define punching above its weight class the most. Let's find out how they compare in the next
14 minutes and 30 seconds.
But before, if you are interested in more videos such as this one, then feel free to subscribe to this channel. This will greatly help my goal of reaching 10k subscribers at the end of 2022. As always, I separated this review into 7 chapters. You can jump right between them in the timeline below if you are searching for something special. Chapter 1. Design and fit. To some, this is the most important category of all. To some others, it isn't even something to think about twice. I'm somewhere in the middle with this, and I have to say I don't like the design language Soundcore has chosen. A wild mix of plastic in different variations. They remind me of the older style type of earbuds like the XM3s, which always had the problems of being really noticeable in my ears, no matter how I've worn them. And I'm absolutely not a fan of anything glossy, especially not when it comes to things I have to grab with my fingers all the time to get them in and out and, well, all around. And then, when comparing them with the case, you'll actually see what I mean. The case is matte black, with a little shiny Soundcore logo finish. It actually looks nice, and that's what I expected the buds to have as a finish as well. But that is all the good things I have to actually say about the case, which in my opinion is way too big for what it holds in terms of battery charging capability. And the mechanism to open the lid is rather clunky, making the one function awkward in which it actually has to shine. Getting the buds out of the shell? Heh, maybe it's my fingers, maybe I'm used to better mechanisms, or maybe it's the case. But when both buds are inserted, it is tedious to get them out without grabbing the tips. And then Soundcore added a flashing light into the case that, well, it looks nice, but the value it actually has is so-so. And when taking the buds out of the case, you first have to actually rotate them 90 degrees before inserting them into your ears and then rotating them for another 45 degrees. It's just a mess. Soundcore, it's those small things that make or break things, and I'd love to see an improvement on the case and the buds in the 4 Pros when they are actually released. The fit, on the other hand, is good. Much better than I originally expected, even though they are clearly noticeable due to the wingtips touching your ears, holding the buds in place after getting them in. With 4 different tips to choose from, there's plenty of room for everyone to get the perfect fit, which is necessary for good sound quality, as well as great ANC in the end. Even without the buds turned on, they close down your ears very well, making them effectively the best and most expensive earplugs that I've ever used. Wearing them for 2 hours while testing them with different music, podcasts and so on, I had no problems with aching or discomfort. This makes them a much better alternative to the XM3s when you are looking for this style of shaped earbuds. Chapter 2. The battery life. Battery life should be the strong point of the Liberty 3 Pros due to their parent company being one of the big players in terms of consumer battery tech, namely Anker. And I'm happy to say they don't disappoint. Soundcore claims 8 hours of battery life without ANC. In my test it was roughly 7 hours and 40 minutes, which is still very good. Turning ANC on, the battery life drops to a proclaimed 6 hours, which in reality is more like 5 hours and 30 minutes roughly, which is still good, but not much better than other competitors in the market, hence the Beats Studio Buds or the Sony XM3s, which come in at the same price range. For mid-range earbuds, this is good, but nothing that actually justifies the hype built around them. Chapter 3. features and the app. Maybe it is not the looks or the battery life that makes these earbuds stand out. Potentially, yeah. It could be all the features that Soundcore prominently displays in all of the advertisements, such as the recommendations by 20 Grammy-winning producers, and according to this fine gentleman, Daryl Thorpe, the Liberty 3 Pros are the most accurate true wireless in-ears he has ever heard. But let's stop right there for a moment and really look at all the features that they've included. ACCA 2.0. A very fancy name for a coaxial dual 10.6mm driver that is actually smaller than its predecessor's 11mm driver. Dual drivers are able to produce a clearer sound, splitting the highs and the lows into two separate channels, but more on that when it comes to sound quality. Hear ID, Soundcore's own testing profile that generates different tones based on your ability to hear different sounds, creating a profile that is tweaked to your unique earring profile. It claims to do the same that Neura's patented technology does, tweaking not only the sound quality but also the ANC to what you are actually able to hear. Okay, these are very bold claims. In my case, I did not notice any changes in terms of ANC before and after using Hear ID. And in terms of sound quality, it actually got worse. 3D surround sound, yay, let's make this quick. This is a digitally implemented 3D gimmick that is actually destroying the sound quality. It's bad. LDAC Hi-Res sound. I could not test this feature since LDAC is not available on any iPhone. Fusion Comfort technology. I don't know what that should be, but I'm giving them the matter of the doubt here since the comfort levels were fine while testing the buds. Multipoint connection. Okay, this is something I can actually get behind. This should become the de facto standard when it comes to earbuds, being connected with two devices at the same time. It works great and is a feature that still isn't standard, and I don't know why it isn't. But let's look at the app for a second as well. It includes all the necessary things I expected from them, like the Hear ID test, the different EQs to play around with, and you can assign and change all the functions on the fly. Neat? But still nothing that makes it stand out in any way. So, chapter 4, finally, sound quality. This must be it, the one thing that makes them, well, stand out, the thing that generated the hype in the first place, even when everything else is just standard. Sound quality is the most important thing when it comes to earbuds. Connecting them with an iPhone, well, it was no problem. Doing the Hear ID test was also very easy and took only roughly 2 minutes. And then, disillusionment. This is it? What is that might be actually the better question. The app tells me this is actually Soundcore's signature sound profile, something they experimented with to give everyone regarding of age, hearing things or Hear ID profile the best standardized audio experience. And I'm not sure if this is what they had in mind. Yeah, I can hear everything, the mids and some highs are in there. There's a good amount of bass, but everything sounds so, I don't know how to actually describe it. Plasticky, but with a lot of oomph coming from the bass. It clearly isn't balanced well, and especially it is not to my liking. Switching through the different presets inside the Soundcore profile lets you get closer to what you actually like. But with these earbuds, when you gain something on one side, you actually lose something on the other. And now to Hear ID, the thing that piqued my interest the most after having actually a go with the Neura Trues a couple of months ago. And oh my, this actually makes the sound even worse. In my case, it just upped the highs to a point where they actually began to distort in the higher frequencies, and it raised the mids as well. This definitely, without a doubt, is not my hearing profile and not what my ears actually want to hear. Remember when I talked about the Nothing Ear once at the beginning of the video? This is where they actually come swooping in. I wanted to have a reference in terms of sound signature profiles, and since Nothing claims it is specifically tuned by Teenage Engineering, well, three Swedish dudes creating electronics and synthesizers, I thought this would be a good comparison against 20 Grammy winning producers. And I must say, the Nothing Ear ones are way more pleasing to my ears than the Liberty 3 Pros, even without any kind of equalizer settings. A way better mix of bass, mids and highs gives a much nicer, well-rounded soundscape. And we are actually talking about a 90 euro versus a 160 euro earbud. After that, I thought maybe the sound quality has something to do with the connection to my iPhone, so I tried it with my MacBook using both iTunes and Spotify and some MP3s that I had on my MacBook. And I don't know why and how, but the sound got even worse, coming close to what I expect from a $25 cheap AirPod earphone. Interestingly enough, watching YouTube videos, the sound was much clearer and nicer. Listening to podcasts was also fine. My guess is, somehow they are not triggering the software to play with a higher resolution Bluetooth codec when paired. I don't know. But chapter 5, call quality. Let's step away from sound quality and look what happens when you input some sound into the buds.
In normal times, I would be sitting in a nice cafe, drinking a hot latte macchiato, probably with some nice steamed oat milk. By the way, I just found a newly released one in Germany from Alpro. It's called Not Milk. Well, back to topic. At least I can simulate the noisy environment through modern technology to give you a feeling of how they would actually handle these kinds of situations when life gets back to regular.
Chapter 6. Noise cancellation. There is definitely noticeable noise floor when ANC is on. Much more noticeable than any other buds that I've tested this year. When we are already speaking about noisy environments, let's actually try the ANC features as well. Soundcore gives you three options to choose from. Normal, which in this case means actually ANC off. Transparency mode to let voices come in, and the Hear ID ANC, which according to Soundcore is tailored specifically to your hearing and powered by KI technology. Which is something that worked very poorly. Sudden jumps in sound as well as in music, even though there wasn't any change in the noise floor due to me being just at home trying it out. The automated mode is a feature that I opted out rather quickly. I then processed to use the manual mode, which gives you three more options, ranging from weak to strong, which does not do much in terms of blocking out different frequencies overall. There is some more blockage in strong mode, but this is such a minimal difference that in my opinion, one mode would have been plenty enough. In my opinion, most of the reduction actually comes from the proper fit, the ANC itself is just okay. But how does it compare to the Nothing Ear ones? It's almost the same. In terms of blocking out the high frequencies, they are both equally effective. But the Ear ones are actually a tad better in reducing voices as well. Let's make this clear once more. Soundcore is trying to sell you a KI optimized, specifically tailored to your ears, noise cancelling through their Hear ID feature that falls short against a 60 euro cheaper first timer product in which the ANC is also just okay-ish. And the transparency mode is really cheap sounding. It's better to get one earbud out of your ear instead of using the transparency mode. And when it comes to wind noises, they completely fall apart. The wind reduction is bad. That's it. Chapter 7. Audio lag. I haven't found any noticeable audio lag, neither in watching videos nor working on videos. When it comes to gaming, it was fine as well. So what's my conclusion on the Soundcore Liberty 3 Pro? Are they worth the hype that have been built up around them? Are they killer earbuds? Best in their class? No, no, and well, another no. The sound quality is lacking and not as good as I wanted them to be. The ANC isn't as good as I hoped they would be due to the advertising, and in all other categories they are just middle of the pack earbuds. If you want some good earbuds for a good price point, then actually rather go for the Nothing Ear ones. They are better in almost every category except battery life. The Liberty 3 Pros are better there. And now something I'd like to tell you on the way out. Hype is something you shouldn't fall for, and bias is something far worse in terms of objective reviews than actually getting a sponsored product and reviewing it. Because who wants to admit that the money they've spent wasn't well spent in the end? Thank you very much for watching. My name is Leech and I'm off writing the next scripts. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure to subscribe to this channel. There are plenty more of this type of content and many other things available for you to watch. Have a great day, see you around, and goodbye. Thank you.